He is one of the most prolific, popular and influential songwriters in American history. Now, Bob Dylan is selling his entire song catalog to Universal for a reported 9 figures. That makes it one of the biggest music publishing rights deals to date ever in history. A category exploding in this pandemic as live venues stay shut. Jem Aswad is a senior music editor at Variety. He joins us live now from New York via Skype. Jem, thank you so much for being with us. So what do we know about the value of this deal?
The New York Times reported that it was $300 million, but they didn't cite a source for that. We know for a fact it's 9 figures. I would think it's actually higher. I've heard figures more like $400 million, which would make sense because just last week, Stevie Nicks sold 80% of her publishing to Primary Wave for a reported $100 million. And no offense to Stevie, I would think that Dylan's catalog would be worth exponentially more.
I'm sure she's, no offense taken, I'm sure I'll say that. I'll say that on their behalf. But, you know, Bob Dylan really holds a special place in my heart because my parents are from this tiny little village in Nigeria called Oyofu Oye in Enugu. And they fell in love listening to Bob Dylan's music in 1965 in this tiny village in Nigeria. So what do you think this means to Universal just to acquire the rights from a musician that has such international, such global appeal, one of the greatest musical geniuses of our time?
I mean, it's the biggest look they could possibly get. The prestige is completely unbeatable. The only other catalog that compares is the Beatles, and the Beatles catalog simply will probably never be sold. So it's a huge prestigious look for them, and it amps up their publishing division, which is pretty regularly second or third or fourth every quarter. It amps up their power even more. It's a great look for them.
So why do you think that Bob Dylan is doing this now? I mean, he's about 80 years old. Why now in his career, do you think?
There's a number of reasons. It's top of market right now. I mean, everyone thinks that the publishing market is only going to get higher, but the Biden administration is likely to raise capital gains taxes. So if you can get the deal done before there's a new administration, that makes a difference. And also, you know, he may be thinking about his heirs. You know, like it's probably easier just to give them money than to give them a complicated catalog that has to be managed because it was administered by his own company here in the United States. And, you know, that's the sort of headache that parents a lot of the time don't want to leave their kids with, so it's a lot simpler just to give them the money.
That is interesting. So I'm sure $400 million or $300 million, no small chunk of change there. So Bob Dylan's songs have been recorded about 6,000 times. I mean, just talk to us about, you know, obviously this is hugely prestigious for Universal, but like the profitability of this as well.
Well, the profitability is potentially astronomical because in selling his catalog, Bob Dylan gives up the right to determine where these songs are going to be licensed. There may be provisions in the deal somewhere, like, you know, they might not be able to license it to, I don't know, Pornhub or somebody like that. But, you know, and also Dylan hasn't shown a whole lot of compunction over, you know, I mean, he licensed the song to Victoria's Secret, so it's really not, you know, I would expect that's probably as blue as it might get. But, you know, in terms of what they can make from it, in addition to earning all the songwriter royalties and all the publishing royalties, they can license it essentially anywhere they want. And for a brand to be able to license positively 4th Street or The Times They Are a-Changin' or any number of his songs, it, to say nothing of some of the lesser known songs that people that might not be top of mind, a song like Mozambique, since you're talking about Africa. You know, there's enormous potential there that they can exploit for decades to come because Dylan's catalog shows no sign of becoming irrelevant, which is something, I don't mean irrelevant, but fading from popular view, which is what happens with a lot of, you know, like a big songwriter from the 80s or something like that.
Jem Aswad, we have to leave it there. Great discussion. Thank you so much.